Hello everyone, welcome to Cerritos College. This is our finishing room, and I'm going to show you how to dry mount a print today, photographic print. I found one in the drawer here that had been abandoned, so I'm going to start off with taking this sheet of dry mounting tissue, which is basically just piece of dried glue, and I'm going to place it on the back of this 8x10 inch print. This little thingamajig here is called a tacking iron. It's very hot, can burn you, can scar you, so be very careful with it. I have it set on medium. What I'm going to do is I'm going to tack down the tissue to the print. So I'm going to make four little marks, very gentle marks, towards the center of the print. Don't do it towards the outside, do it towards the center. If you do this too long, you will melt the print. Okay, so the next thing to do is to trim the print. We have these rotor trimmers here. Some people like to pull towards them and some people like to push away. I'm a pusher. Short people like to pull. There's a little piece of metal here and a piece of plastic that you can use as a guide. So that first cut is the most important one. I'm sorry if I'm going out of focus here, but I'm doing this all alone because of the pandemic. Okay, so then I'm going to hold the print down with a ruler, push away from me. Notice I'm wearing white gloves so I don't get fingerprints on my print. Now I have one clean edge, so I'm going to put that clean edge against the top and position my the right edge so that I can get as much of the print as possible. In other words, I'm going to trim off the white borders. A big mistake some people make is they trim their print and then they put the tissue on. And if you do it that way, what's going to happen is you're going to have to trim it again. Because the tissue and the print need to be exactly the same size. So if I'm very careful here, and I push against the straight edge on the back, I'm going to get a print with parallel edges. So the next thing to do is to decide whether you want to use the white side or the black side. Personally, I prefer the white side. Graphic arts applications usually are mounted with a black side, but photography, we usually go for the white side. Do as you please. Notice, this is what happens if you don't use acid-free board. Yes, that is me a few years ago, in, say 1975. This board used to look just like this one, white, not acid-free. Okay, so you get for what you pay for, basically. So I need to center this print. So that's going to involve either mathematics or a piece of paper. The choice is yours. If you want to do it with mathematics, you push the print towards the edge of the board. You measure how much is left. In this case, I have 4 1 2 3 4 5/8. So that would mean if I go here 2 5/16 and make a little mark, then if I bring that edge to that mark. Now it should be centered. Now another way of doing it, if you're like me and not good at math, which was a problem because my father was a math teacher, take a piece of paper, put it up against the edge of the print, make a crease where the edge of the board is, fold it over. Okay, that's the same as measuring it. Fold it in half. That's the same as dividing by two. Woo-hoo. And lo and behold, exactly the same measurement. Okay? So then we have to do that with the top and bottom. Let's go ahead and do it the easy way with the paper. It's a little tricky with gloves on. Folding two. Well, some people like to leave, you know, a little bit more on the bottom than the top. And some people like to center. So either way is fine. Whatever you like. But don't have it all crooked and cockeyed. Then you need a very sharp pencil with a soft lead that can be erased. When you do erase your pencil marks later on, make sure to use a white eraser. Do not use a pink eraser because that will damage the board and leave a mark. So the next thing is to take a T-square, place that along the edge of your board, and then line that up with your bottom mark. And I take my print and line up the bottom with the side. Now at this point, it's usually helpful to have a cell phone or something to put on top of your print. I left mine in my office, so do without as a kind of weight. Before you commit yourself and tack this down again, you need to make sure it looks good. So just eyeball it. I moved it. So it moved. That's where the cell phone would come in handy. Okay. Now I'm going to lift up the edge of the print and tack the corner. That's why I didn't want to tack the corner when I tacked it to the mounting tissue, because I need to be able to lift the corner. Once you've lifted those, tack those first two corners, it's not going to move. You can tack the remaining two corners. Now our tissue and our print are exactly the same size, centered on the board. I'm going to pause the video for a moment and go over to the mounting press to show you the rest of the process. Alright, so now we're going to put our print in the mounting press. We have to make sure that there's something between the very hot press and our print. Otherwise, our print will melt. It will also damage the press. So, you need a cover sheet. Place the print face up in the center. And when you're ready, time this for about a minute. Now, depending on how hot the press is, what kind of paper you're using, what kind of mounting tissue you're using, what kind of board you're using, the results will vary anywhere between 30 seconds and 4 minutes, how long you need to do this. But usually about 1 minute will work. Do not jack up the temperature, that will probably melt the next person's print. Better that it's too cold than it's too hot, because if it's too hot, it will melt. And so it will either melt so that all the tissue, the mounting tissue melts into the board, or worse yet, it will also melt the print. If it's too cold, then you just put it in again for longer. So we're up to 51 seconds here. This doesn't have to be exact. Okay. Once I take it out, nice. I'm gonna make sure the edges aren't popping up. And then I'm gonna put it in the cold press. This is optional, but the cold press will help it from warping. You wanna print when it gets very dry or humid, the boards start to curl. You put it in the cold press right after taking it out of the hot press, leave it there for 30 seconds or a minute or so. While it cools down, it will tend to warp less. So that completes the demo on how to dry mount. Easy peasy. Let me know if you have any questions, and have a wonderful day.